Hello, folks, and we're right back to... Oh, because it's been stopped. Blast. We're right back to... Let's get some six out of that. Good. We're back to Winter's Story, where we are... At the moment, I'm wanting to see how many refractory bricks I can get into Pitkill. That's my current job. At the same time, we are, again, waiting for things to grow, because I want to get my 64. I put some fertilizer down here. Might need to... Moisture's pretty good. That's fallow, though. Onions are growing. Oh, my crops are growing as well. Yep. Looking forward to this flax being done. Oh my god, am I looking at the flax being done? Right, okay. The wind has currently stopped, unfortunately. So my quartz chunks are not getting crushed. Because the plan, of course, was to see if I could... So yeah, I made the quartz pit over here, and I've got the four quartz bricks in there. So the six unfired refractory bricks. But it, given the depth, it looks like I might be able to put more in there. Maybe six more. Hell, maybe even more than that. Maybe nine more. So 12 more. I'll make six first and put those in. But for that, I need this to finish crushing, please. Come on, wind, blow. Ah. Anyway, let's have a quick look. While we're waiting for that to happen, let's have a quick look at the cattle. How's our cattle doing? Cattle? Not cattle. Our sheep. Is there a word for sheep that means for like... Is there a word like cattle, but for sheep? Because cattle means cows. Generation 1. Okay, my... Generation 1. Yeah. Generation 2 lambs, but they're still bloody lambs. Okay, let's get some more grass for them. I'm going to get the grass. I'm actually going to grab both of these. I'll be farming grass next to the windmill, because if I hear the windmill go, I can carry on. There's plenty of grass to be grabbed everywhere. So if I hear the windmill go... I think I'm not a huge fan of that tower, to be honest. I've spent so much making that, I'm not a huge fan of it at this point. And... It might be a bit too tall. I should probably mess around in, like, creative or something, and just see, like, how much friction my axle's currently generating. Thought I heard it there. Bunch of grass. Oh my god, this is lasting longer than I'm expecting it to. Thank you. Replaced immediately with the tin bronze one. Get three stacks of grass at least. Can work with three stacks of grass. Okay, it's 1st of April, so, you know, prank time and all that. If I'd been planning ahead, I would have totally, like, made a prank for this episode, but I guess I had to just kind of occurred to me now. It must be in April by this point. I get 1st of April. Hi. Welcome to April. How are we doing? Two snacks now. And... And why I'm doing this, the reminder why we're doing this, is because I want to be able to make, I want to have a Helve hammer. Why I'm doing this is to get sheep, but why I'm waiting for not to go to the translocator, because people are probably dying for me to get into that translocator. I want to get the Helve hammer up and running, because I'm damned if I'm going to be hammering out more plates. Hammering out plates is the epitome of boredom, which is, you know, sounds rich coming from someone who's currently just scything a bunch of He's just scything a bunch of stuff here, but I know what I mean. That's enough. That's enough. Oh my god, wind, can you please? Can you please, wind? Right. Let's go. Turn. So I need to get the... 6 more of this stuff, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There you go. Now... Oak sapling. Right, okay, we've got plenty of wood. I mean, our forest finally came back up, so I'm not too concerned about that. Mix that out there. There we go. 8, 8, 8, 8. Okay, good. There's still a bit of coldness around here. The thaw should be here by now, but I guess it's not entirely. Let's be fair, it's 5 degrees, folks. This water should be melting. I guess it's slightly colder over here than it is over there. Let's have a quick look at the leather. I don't see the windmill vanes turning. Is it because this is just too low? Even this is too low, it's too much friction. The prepared hide. Got you. Put the repaired hide in there. The rawhide medium can go into here. Scraped hide small can go into here. Right, fine. Please, I'll go up there and I'll go. If it makes a difference. Because you get a bonus to mechanical power for every square it goes up. But I'm assuming that bonus to mechanical power must outweigh the friction penalty you have for running an axle that high. Or are you supposed to run your workshop really high off the ground? Well. So what I'm going to do now then, you know what? Fine. Because I am slightly curious and I want to make some space here. Let us grab 2 metal parts. Really? I heard you. You made a single clunk over there and then you stopped. Bloody Metal Gear Solid. What was that noise? Alright, I'm going to pick up the temporal gears as well. I think it's 3 temporal gears I require. Is it? Well, we're about to find out. Alright, let's go. Let's hop down into the caves. Let's hop down into these caves here. Let's head down here. Past the... I knew there was a quartz layer somewhere. I also need a new sword if we're going to do this as well, actually. Come to think of it. Right. That's repaired, and it's 3. 1, 2, 3. And that is a repaired static translocator. That's currently working. Hey, buddy. That's ready for us whenever we are ready for it. I have no idea what that's going to be, but you're done. I'm terrified of you, but you are there. You're done. Come on, give me more of this beautiful, beautiful flux twine. Please. I think we're so close to the required forest. I'm pretty sure that... I have no basis for this. I'm not sure what I'm saying. I'm pretty sure. I hope that one extra set of sails will give enough persistent power, as long as there is some kind of wind, to deal with at least the pulverizer running more often. You might need more sets of sails to do the Helve Hammer. Right, okay. There you go. You back here yet? No, it's still refusing to blow. Bloody wind. Yeah, well, we're waiting for that then. Might as well go have a look. Might as well go have a look at what people have to sell. Might pop down to the Cassiterite Caves. Haven't been there in ages. To see what it's like. It's been so long. Someone mentioned in comments a while back now that the Cassiterite ore disc was at an angle, and therefore it would be harder to find Cassiterite. But we'll have a check. As usual, I'm going to probably have issues finding the damn Cassiterite, but hey. Cassiterite was north of that patch of dwarf grass over there. I think it's called, is that called dwarf grass? Got some spelt over here. Dwarf furs. Dwarfs. Like it's like Colin furs, but it's a dwarf. Dwarf furs. And so it's there. It's ridiculously well, I remember this being ridiculously well hidden from this angle. I think it's literally that patch over there. Like there. Okay. Well, let's quickly look at what the trader has for sale. I'm interested to see the new traders look. These are all the old traders. These are all the old traders' designs. So once you go to Translocator, I hope. Hey, buddy. Some haylight. I wouldn't mind buying haylight, actually. Simple bow, tin bronze pitaxe, some arrows, tin bronze spear, axes, fur gloves. Have we got any gloves? I am going commoner's gloves, which is, I'm assuming, is the fur gloves area. This all damage to hell, anyway. You're buying leather off me though, so I can 10 leather will give me 5. Okay, that's not too bad. 10 ingots, eh. Copper lanterns. 3 gears for 2 copper lanterns. 2 copper lanterns is 6 copper bars. There's 2 copper bars per lantern. No, 4 copper bars per lantern because it's 2 plates. Right. Oh, it's okay, so it's 1. There's 2 copper bars. What's the candle? That's the problem, is the bloody candles. I haven't got the bloody candles. I can't make lanterns because I haven't got bloody candles. Ah! Curses! Adding gold or silver lining increases the light level. Craft by including a gold plate in the crafting grid. Huh? Basically, that's the lined copper lanterns. Light level 20, light level 18, I guess. Glass plane and glass quartz. Brass lantern, black bronze lantern, bismuth lanterns, bismuth bronze lantern. You can make a bismuth lantern? Really? So bismuthanite, you can make bismuth bits or bismuth plates, or you can smelt for bismuth bronze. But if you make the bismuth plate, you can make the Archimedes screw with the port, you can make a bismuth block. You can also make the lanterns. Bismuth lantern with quartz, bismuth lantern with gold lining with quartz, silver lining with quartz, plain with gold, plain with silver. Intriguing. Yeah, honk honk yourself. Yeah. A gold lantern is off by. Interesting. Cheers, buddy. Huh. And I've got a bunch of bismuth. I mean, that's the way to use it. I don't think I'm going to be making bismuth bronze anymore. Unless I'm specifically finding some zinc to work with. And then zinc, I might as well just be making brass. Because brass has got uses that only brass can do. Right, let's have a quick gander what's happening down here then. Oh, there's so much ladder I could harvest here. Right, we're down here. Where is... Well, the Cassiterite's probably this way. Cassiterite was... this way, question mark? Let's grab the... I'm going to need you, don't I? Over this way. There's been a lot of mining down here. I'm assuming we've cleared out the Cassiterite. I assume we've done that already. No, give me node search, thank you. Trace amounts of Cassiterite. Okay. Oh dear. Help. Fine. Right. Technically we're past Cassiterite. I'm okay saying that we're past Cassiterite now. We're past bronze at this point. We're in the iron tier. I've got enough bronze to keep me going, but I've got plenty of iron to work with. Hey, buddies. How's it going? Jesus, no! I need to eat something. Good. Right. Back home we go. Okay. Up, 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 up. I can just see some light over there. Give me my quartz, please. I know it's going to take ages. It's going to take a long time for. It takes what, 24 in-game hours for a firewood. Pit kiln. Oh, didn't take any damage. Really? Didn't take any damage there. How interesting. That was the marble. Good. Oh my god, that's what started all this, isn't it? That is literally it. I remember now. That's what started my entire I want to get to steel, because I want the... Wow, that's petty. I want pink cream marble tabletops, and to do that I need to have the ability to work meteoric iron. Which means I need to have an iron anvil. Which means I might as well start working away towards steel. I remember. Okay, I can see the silhouette of the windmill. I see a little silhouette of a windmill. Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the windmill? This is so much weirder with all the trees around here now. Again, you still haven't... You still have... No, fine, whatever. Whatever. Whatevs. Yo. Let's have a nap. Temperature is 7. And see how cold it goes overnight. Waking up. Temperature's minus 2. Yeah. Well, it's early still, so it's still going to go down a bit before it goes up again. Okay, let's... Oh, come on, please. Thank you. Wow. I definitely think. How are we doing on... Come on. Give me so much work with. How are we doing here? 6s out of 9s. Come on. 6s out of 9s. 6s out of 7. So the onions are going to be done pretty soon. The nitrogen is weak here. I'm going to keep an eye on those two squares there. Because those two squares there are problematic. Stopped again. Damn it! Thank you. It is slow going. Okay, right. It's like it knows I'm watching. I wonder how much better it's gonna be. Was it 25% power for every additional? Is it worth doing a second one? Can you do a second one? If you only get 25% power for each additional set of scales, sails, then surely it's worth it to have a second windmill. Because let's say, okay, let's assume if one set of sails gives you 100% power, then two sets of sails 125, three sets 150, four sets 175, five sets 200, then two windmills with one set of sails each will give you 200% power. I mean, I could put the second windmill there, couldn't I? Oh, you didn't even crush the second one. You didn't even crush the bloody second one, Jesus. You just spit it out. In the meantime, what else can we look into? I want to look into... apparently a peat fire pit works better than a firewood one. And I seem to recall peat over there. Other side of the lake. Which is mostly melted, but still has patches of ice in it. Is it still... I was going to say, is it traversable by ice? The personal, it would be cool if in like when it's warm there's a chance for ice to break if you walk over it. It's technically traversable, I'm just not very good at them. This is a jumping puzzle with ice physics and therefore I hate it. Thank you, helicopter outside, very thematically appropriate. Now there was peat around here somewhere, I think. Grass. There you go, peat. Ah! Let's pick up some peat. Apparently peat. Peat fire kiln works better than a peat pit kiln works better than a firewood peat kiln. So we'll get some peat for the pit kilns. I have no idea if this is true. Not a clue if this is true or not. I'm just going to figure it out. This is a scientific experiment of sorts. We got almost two stacks worth, so. I forgot to stay on stack up to 27. To 32. Have a spare one. Okay, good. Right. I'm gonna try to do this jumping game a little bit more religiously on the way back. Fine, let's give this a shot. Seems like I can do this without falling into the water then. Chickens in the, that's just an amusing sight. Oh god. Jump here. And jump here. And jump here. Oh god. Hey, it can be done. That massive challenge we just had. Fine, whatever. Hi wolf. Hi wolf. Such a pointless event. Such a pointless minigame. Oh, no matter what. What the hell? How? What? I'm not hallucinating, right? I found it here. with some leather there, good. Go on, make those two while I'm gonna go sell some leather real quick. Well, because leather is an infinite resource, that's why. I'm just justifying that to myself. Leather is an infinite resource, so might as well go grab some. Sorry, yeah, guys, might as well sell five for five, or eight. And what was it? We're selling a certain amount for a certain amount. I think it was five or one. Was it? Doesn't matter. I can only have eight with me. That might be four gears worth. Was it two for one gear? And the worst exchange rate in the world. Up here. The bow stave is done, correct? The problem with that is that it requires a bunch of flax twine, and the priority is not the bow stave, unfortunately. The priority is definitely sales. Right, okay, so we shall sell leather to this man. X. This is four gears worth. Thank you. You're also buying flax and rye bread. What can I buy with four gears? I can buy 12 halite. I can buy a simple bow. I can buy several beds. I can buy one bed, in fact. I can buy a bronze armlet for no points at all. I can buy a tin bronze spear. Buy a tin bronze pickaxe. Okay, that's five. I keep thinking I've got five. I don't know if I've got four. I can buy the fur gloves. I can't just buy the fur gloves. Not that I need them at the moment, but I could just buy them. You know what? Yes, I will buy the fur gloves. Yeah, can you know what? Yes, I will. Yes, I will buy the fur gloves. I'll keep them for next winter, which will probably never arrive because I don't think the series is going on for that long. But hey, maybe the series does go on for that long. Hi, Wolf. Okay, we need an armor. Get another armor, still doing okay. How much leather did I need again? It was like 40-something leather, wasn't it? For a full set of armor. Although, again, the armor we want is once we have, again, a bunch of flax, is the linen gambeson stuff. Linen gambeson stuff is way better. If I open my... this at the same time. Gambeson. That's what? 700 durability for flat damage reduction of 60%. This is a 900 durability for flat damage reduction of 70%. Flat 0.7%. Has a bit of effectiveness changes to my hunger, etc. But it's also high tier damage resistance. Yes, this is fantastic. This is very helpful. This is very, very good. Why, is my question there. Why is linen stuff that much better than leather stuff? I'm sure your leather armor would be better than linen. Like, a linen gambeson would go under other armor. If you could put the linen gambeson, like, in this slot, that would make more sense. Because you put the armor in the clothes slot, then wear a leather jacket on top of it. Are you spinning? No, you're not spinning. Damn you, spin more. Overrising nothing. Why did you end up over there? What? Why are you doing that? You are spinning. I want to see this happen. I want to see. I'm going to take a step away. I want to see this happen. How do you end up over there? Oh, come on. Come on. Today's just me begging the bloody windmill to just blow. I'm gonna... Come on, I heard you. I heard you. Okay, you're over there again. Fine. Whatever. That goes there, that goes there, that goes there. Grab those. Now, can I put this on top of that one then? Yeah, I think that's probably all I can get in there. Is it though? Is it though? Or can I get one more layer in there? We're about to find out. Six there. One, two, three, four, five, six. There. Damn it, I put it back in there. He said it. Another 12 of this stuff. Right, let's go put the... Can I put this on you? Can I put dresses or other non-armor arms? It's fine. Is there a wardrobe of some kind? No. There's a Forlorn Hope Talisman. Forlorn Hope Talisman, they sought to link this inferno memory and wield it directly. Much of their efforts were directed towards. Now, I wonder where the word ward was in that. We don't have enough planks for... We don't, do we? No. Okay, so I need to make some more planks. I need more logs, which I'm going to cut the tree down. Let's cut down a pine. Let's cut down a pine, make more pine logs. Make a chest and put some clothing items in the chest. Good. Give me the saw. What time is it? Oh, look at the time. Okay. That goes there. That goes there. That goes there. That goes there. Pack of dirt goes back up there. Peat brick, whatever. Give me that. That goes in there. Good. I'm gonna put this over here for the fur gloves. Right. Alright, folks, I'm gonna call it there for now. I think next time we'll see if we can get one more layer of peat brick, of refractory bricks in there. If not, fine. If yes, fine. Anyway, folks, I'll catch you all next time. Have a good one. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.